بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Assalamu alaikum fam, welcome everybody. Today I want to talk to you guys about something that I feel is very important. There was an incident that happened last week in a comment section on one of my videos, which made me realize that this has to be addressed before I continue with my usual dawah content. Now, you guys know that normally I make videos directed towards our Christian and non-religious brothers and sisters, but this video is going to be different as it's meant specifically for the Muslim Ummah, my Shia and Sunni fam, you in particular. You know, when I converted to Islam, somehow by the will of Allah, the mosque that I went to officially convert ended up being a Shia mosque, and it ended up being a day of Khadir Qom. At that time, I didn't know this, and even when I heard, it didn't mean anything to me because I was a new Muslim and, you know, everything sounded foreign and I pretty much knew nothing. There was a lot of people in the mosque and everyone was very loving and they even got me a cake, you know, and I love cakes, so I still remember that. And actually, it was pretty funny because it was my first time at the mosque and I was used to these Christian Orthodox churches with like pictures and candles and, you know, chanting inside and whatnot. So when I got to the mosque inside, I was looking around to find a prayer room and I couldn't find anything that resembled it in my mind. And a sister there asked me if I was looking for something. So I said, yes, where are your... And I paused because I didn't want to say God or saints, but I didn't know how to word myself. So I said, where is your what you pray towards? And I'll never forget the look at her face because she looked so confused. She's like, what do you mean? We pray right here. And I look around and there is nothing there besides like rugs on the floor. You know, no candles, no pictures, nothing. And it was like this weird, you know, moment of confusion, and then it hits me, of course, you know, it's one God, no graven images, just stand and pray. It was literally like a light bulb in my mind that went off, and for the first time ever, I felt my prayer is now directed truly towards God and no one and nothing else. To me, first time seeing a group of Muslims together like this, praying and just as a community, it was really amazing, you know, that day I heard a lot about Allah and about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Quran, and at some point name Fatima was mentioned. So I asked who that was, and the ladies there told me that she was the daughter of her Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and that they love her very much for her character and wisdom and many other things. Now, I didn't know much about Prophet Muhammad himself or his daughter or family or anyone. I only heard, you know, the Quran, and I went to a mosque to follow God's call. But I wanted to know more about this woman, you know, Fatima. So I asked. And they told me that, you know, her husband's name was Ali, and their children were Hassan and Hussein, alayhi salam, and that Ali was the first male Muslim after the Prophet, supporting him since childhood, and that Ali's father was the one who took care of our Prophet when he himself was an orphan child. They told me that Fatima died young, you know, shortly after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Hassan and Hussein were left without, you know, a mother and a grandfather basically, and that Ali took care of them and raised them until he himself became a martyr. This was the first time that I heard the term Ahl Bayt, and that it refers to these people, the family of our Prophet. Up until then, I only had love for Allah and Quran, but things I learned that day awakened another feeling in me. It awakened the love for our Prophet and for his family. It was a while later until I learned that there is such a thing as Sunni and who think differently than what I got used to by that point, who say they follow the Sunnah or traditions of Prophet and, you know, they have a lot of love for the Sahaba, Prophet's companions. I saw no issues. I also loved the Sahaba and I was also seeking to follow the Sunnah. I thought that everyone was, you know, like me. Everyone loved the Ahl Bayt and everyone loved the Sahaba and we all have only one Sunnah, the Sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I was thinking, you know, that Sunnah just has some variations depending on whose point of view it came from. I mean, two people can hear and see the same thing, but interpret it, you know, differently. I felt that having differences is normal. That's what makes us human. But we love Allah and accept Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a messenger of God. So we are fulfilling our shahada, and that makes us all Muslims, family to each other. I was very surprised when I found out that there's some conflict going on between Muslims who call themselves Shia and say they love Ahlul Bayt, and Muslims who call themselves Sunni and say they love the Sahaba. I couldn't believe it. Like, why? Allah gave us the perfect book and the perfect religion, and instead of inviting the world to Islam in peace and unity and setting an example as community for the rest of the planet, we pick up the Book of Allah, set it down, and argue for a thousandth of years about who deserves to be loved more and who is more important and what happened after we got the perfect revelation from Allah and our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. Like, is this even reality, fam? It's true that there are some differences between these schools of thought, but these differences are not related to Allah or the Quran, so they should not break the bond, the family bond we have as Muslims. Muslims being disrespectful to each other just because they belong to a different school of thought is really unacceptable. Here's the reality, fam. If we want Islam and Muslims to flourish, we cannot give in to Shaitan's plan of dividing and conquering us. We have the strength only in unity, because division in all these years gave us nothing. Fam, many of you who watched this channel before know that I'm following my vision of Islamic States of America. American people deserve to hear the message of Islam and have a chance at salvation. There are many forces that are pulling them away from God. American people are oppressed spiritually and emotionally. We are the ones that they're counting on. If we don't deliver the message of their creator to them, then what are we gonna say, you know, in front of God when they will bear witness against us that we failed to help them and to inform them of the knowledge and guidance that Allah had blessed us with? Fam, we Muslims of the 21st century should find no time to sit around and allow ourselves to focus on our differences rather than the vision and responsibility that unites us. And that is spreading the message of Islam to every community, every person on the planet. I want to inform every American about Islam. This will be the first step to something amazing. For this, I will need the support of all Muslims. Fam, how sad and embarrassing it was for me to see a brother from one school of thought show support in the comment section last week, only for another brother from a different school of thought to shame him and speak rudely to him. Fam, we should be better than this. We had 1400 years to argue. Isn't that enough? We have to use our love for Allah and our love for our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to patch up our reactions to our differences. Let each other just be each other and transform our division into unity with one goal, one God, one love, and one religion for all. Do you feel the importance of what I'm trying to say? Fam, Allah will explain to us, inshallah, on Judgment Day about what really happened in history. For us now, it is unseen. So let's love each other for the sake of Allah, and let's unite on big goals and on beautiful things that are awaiting us in our future. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us peace within the ummah. May He open our hearts to unity, strengthen our iman, and open the doors for us to achieve things that are worthy of His acceptance. Thank you, fam, for watching. Subscribe for weekly uploads. Don't forget to like and comment. And I'll see you guys next week, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.